In this guide, I'm going to show you how you can remove the black bars on Amazon Prime or while watching a video or movie on Amazon Prime, and how you can actually stretch the video to full screen or almost full screen if you have a really wide or an ultra wide monitor. So this applies to any monitor you have, but this also applies to those who have a really wide or a curved monitor. So let's get started. So there will be three parts to this tutorial. The first is I'm going to show you how you can do this on Google Chrome. Second is Microsoft Edge, which is exactly the same. Just a process, just a couple of things are a bit different. And the third is Mozilla Firefox. If you have any other browsers, you can use this on Brave as well. I believe you can install these extensions from Chrome on Brave as well. So this should work. I haven't tried it, unfortunately. And if you have any other browsers that you need me to have a look at, leave them in the comments. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to utilize a plugin that is available for free on the Chrome Web Store. So make sure you're logged in to your Amazon Prime and all that stuff first. And if you like a step-by-step guide or a written guide, please go to the link in the description where I have the link to the article on windowsloves.com, which goes into the detail on the exact same things, including screenshots and all that stuff. Or you can just bookmark it so that you can come back to it later when you need it. So the first thing, as you can see, is we're going to go to the Chrome Web Store and install an application called Zoom to Fill Ultra Wide Video. So first, we're going to go to the Chrome Web Store, and you can click on the left and search the store. So I'm going to search for Zoom to Fill. As you can see, it's featured as well, and it is trusted by a lot of other users as well. As you can see, it says it removes videos, black bars on Netflix, Disney Plus, HBO Max, Amazon Prime. I haven't tested on other applications. I've tested Netflix. It does work. So if you want to use it for Netflix as well, that's fine. For the purpose of this video, I'm going to try it out on Amazon Prime, which is a bit tricky as compared to Netflix. So once you are on the page, click on Add to Chrome, click on Add Extensions. As you can see, it has been added. Right, so it says Zoom to Fill. It's just an introduction on what's new and how you can use it as well. So I'm just going to show you that quickly in a second. You can close that. And if you're not aware, you can pin the extensions. In the past, it wasn't the case, but now you need to pin them so that you can have quick access to them. So as you can go, so you can see all the extensions that I installed on my application on my computer are here. So I'm just going to pin it, and I have an access. So this is the extension. So what you need to do now is you go back to your Prime Video. I would just do a quick refresh just in case that the extension is recognized by the website or the website is accessible by the extension. And what you do is you just play any video. For example, I'm just going to play this video. Just continue watching. And as you can see, there's a new option here that says click to zoom, scroll to adjust. Now, let's say you're watching this series and you go full screen, and then you can see there's bars on top and bottom. Okay, I've told you that this is a 49 inch screen, but I'm currently recording on 1920x1080, so the only space I have is on the top and on the bottom. If you have a wider screen, you will have black bars on the left and the right as well. Now, if you click on that, what it does, it basically crops the video and technically gives you an illusion that it's actually filling the entire screen. Now, if you have a normal size screen, let's say 21 inches or 27 inches on, and you have a decent and you have a standard aspect ratio monitor, then this extension will work really good and it will look like all the bars are removed. But in case you have a ultra wide monitor, which in this case I do, what happens is there will be some space on left or right side of the screen. You can decide to remove that as well, but that will increase the zoom a lot. So what I mean by that is, for example, if the zoom by default, the default zoom is not enough for you, what you can do is you close that, you click on that extension, and as you can see, you can choose an aspect ratio that is perfect for your monitor, or you can increase the aspect ratio, or you can increase the amount that it crops or zooms in. For example, if I go 1.12 1.25, continue watching, you can actually increase that. So if you go back, you can actually increase that while the video is playing as well. As you can see, it's zooming in, right? So you just got to play around and find the perfect fit for your monitor and the aspect ratio as well. So now that differs depending on how that particular video you're watching. if that video is shot on, exported on different aspect ratios as well. So you just got to find a perfect fit for every show or every TV, for every movie or every video you watch on Prime Video. So that's how you done. It's done on Google Chrome. I'm going to show you how it's done on Microsoft Edge, but I'm just going to show you how you install the extension, and everything else remains exactly the same for Edge. So if I go switch to Edge, I have my Prime Video open already. It's going to go full screen. Now, what you want to do is you want to install the extension first. So it's the exact same extension. The reason behind that is because the new Edge is built on top of Chromium, which is the basis or the base for Google Chrome as well. That's what Google Chrome is built on top. So this is built on top of the same stuff that Google Chrome is built on. So the extensions are compatible with each other. All right, you got to remember that you are installing the extension that is available on the Chrome Web Store. So if you go and search for the extension on Microsoft Edge add-ons page, you won't find it. So you got to go to Google search, or if you have a direct link to the Chrome Web Store, you can use that as well. I'm just going to go Chrome Web Store, just go to Google search, open that Web Store, and as you can see, it says you can now add extension. So I'm just going to search for Zoom to Fill. And as you can see, this is the exact same extension because we are on the same web store. Now open that, and as you can see, it says add to Chrome. It doesn't say add to Edge, but that's fine. It will work regardless. Add extension, and as you can see, the extension has been installed. So now you can go back to the Prime Video and do the exact same thing and adjust depending on how you would like. Now let's jump on to Firefox and how to remove black bars on Amazon Video for Firefox or the Prime Video extension, if you are familiar with that. So if I open Mozilla Firefox and if I go and search for add-ons and themes, right, find more add-ons, search for Ultra Video. Please note that I'm not typing video, I'm typing video, so Ultra Video. So that's the extension we're going to use. There might be other ones, I haven't tried it. If you have other suggestions, please leave them in the comments so that other users might find it useful. So this is the one I'm using currently and it works for me. So click on that and click on add to Firefox. It's asking a confirmation, click on add, and as you can see, Ultra Video was added, and it's just a thank you page, and you can donate and you can go through the instructions on how to get different things done and shortcuts and all that stuff. I'm just going to show you the basic what I do with this extension. So go to Prime Video. I'm just going to reload the page just in case. If you click on it, there's three modes basically, right? There's shortcuts you can set if you prefer that. There's normal, there's upscale, and there's stretch, right? I don't really use stretch most of the time because it's not a good experience. I'd rather watch a normal tiny square video instead of a stretched one. The option you can use is upscale, basically. You don't have fine tuning and you don't have that granular control over the manner of zoom that you have as compared to Zoom to Fill on Google Chrome or Edge. So you only have the upscale. So if I open the video, let's say I continue watching. All right, so contrary to the other extensions, you don't get any new options. What you get is the upscale. If the extension doesn't seem to be working, just make sure you restart your Firefox browser. That's what I just did. So if I open the video, I play it, I go to full screen, the screen is entirely filled with the video. So that's what you want while we're watching a video. Now what you want to do is, if you want to go back and you want to change it to normal, you got to go pause the video, go to extension, and you go and enable other modes. So you can not disable just that, you got to enable something else. So you got to go normal, or you can just go and pause the extension. So you just go upscale. If you want to stretch it, you can stretch it. You select, you stretch the video, and then you go and play and go full screen. The video will be stretched if there's some space. Like I said, the article is in the description. If you have any question, if you have any queries, or if you have any other better suggestions that can make this guide a bit more helpful for other people, leave them in the comments or reach out to me on Twitter or on the blog. Thank you for being here, and you have a nice day. Check out other helpful guides that other users have found useful and subscribe for more.